and these are the single stream transactions. Again, the screen is divided in three comparison. You can see that vendor 100 is the best vendor and it has a landed cost of 19.79 euros. And if I have to purchase 10 cases, the net amount will be 197.88. The lowest one is considered as 100, and other 6 will show how many, by how much percent they are excess. This is 13% higher and this is 14% higher. And the minimum one is there. Now, this is only a commercial comparison. SAP, any technical comparison will be done outside SAP. That is not there in SAP. So I decided to go ahead with vendor 100 and award this order to this vendor 100. So I want to reject the other two quotations. And if you have configured any output message like any printout or any email communication to the vendor, then system can automatically trigger the rejection letter. For that, you need to reject the quotation. Now, I go to this quotation 92 and I want to reject it. So click on this quotation change. And here you click on this, or that is the rejection button. And save this. This is not the mandatory step, but if you have configured the output message for that, like any print, every company will design their own form and attach it to that output message. Okay, I also want to reject this. Okay, now I want to award this order to vendor 100, and this is the extra number here. Okay. Now, the next step in this cycle is to create a purchase order. So click on this create new session button. And purchase order is created in transaction ME21L. ME21L. Now, again, this ME21N is a new transaction, user transaction, and it has, like, you have the old transaction ME21, which is multi-screen transaction, as we have seen in RFQ. We go through multiple screens to complete one document. Whereas this ME21N, ME51N, these transactions are introduced from 4.7 version, and these are the single screen transactions. Again, the screen is divided in three sections, header, item overview, and item details. You can maintain the default values in the personal settings, and in personal settings, there is tab default values. And say here, I have maintained some default values like document type, purchasing organization, purchasing group, company code. Or you can pull some more for sales also, as we did for the purchase equation. And when I directly go to this transaction, and I go to this organizational data tab, you will see that the default values are automatically populated. Okay. Now, in item overview, if you scroll to the rightmost section of the screen, here you can view the reference document. So, you can create a purchase equation, purchase order, with reference to some purchase equation. You can refer any outline agreement, that is contract, or you can refer any request for quotation, RFQ. Or you can copy a purchase order from old purchasing document, means old purchase order. So I can copy a purchase order from old purchase order also. So these are the reference documents available. Now suppose I want to search RFQ and I want to create this purchase order with reference to that. So I click on this document overview on button. And through this document overview also, you can search the document. So, I click on this button and you will see that these are the various options available. You can find a purchase order, RFQ, contract, scheduling agreement, or you can have this my purchase order. These are the purchase orders created by you, everything. Now, I need the request for quotation and I don't remember that number of the RFQ number of that vendor. So, I will click on this request for quotation. And system will take me to a new selection screen wherein I can use some criteria and select the required document. Okay. So this is your selection criteria. Now what I know is my material number was C188 and the plant was 1000 or vendor was 100. So vendor 100, I want to give this order. Purchasing organization for this. So whatever parameters you will know, you can fill these parameters here. And then click on this execute button. Invoice, whether invoice is possible, any tax code is applicable here. you click on this taxes button, you can see the taxes calculation. Now I have taken a 0% tax, so there will not be any tax on this. Then you can go to the conditions, and in conditions you will see the price and the other terms now come from the RFQ. Like 20 euro was the price, 3% is the freight, and 2% is the, 3% was the discount, 2% of freight. You can give the account assignment as we have seen in the purchase requisition. You can have it for asset, cost center, or any production order, maintenance order, or any project network, etc. We'll see this in details for the procurement versus cost and consumption. You can have the item level text which goes in the PO printout. The delivery address will be copied from the requisition, or you can change it here. So these are the various tax pages which are basically you should know. Whenever you have time, just go through that. Then I click on this check button and there is purchase order. So now this purchase order has been created and issued to the vendor. The next step is when the vendor receives this purchase order, he will send the goods and we'll do the goods receipt. Again, I click on this other document button and click on continue. It will show me the last purchase order created. So this is the last purchase order created and this is the purchase order number. And we have to now receive this goods. Vendor has delivered the material and we have to do the goods receipt. I'll create one session here and that is done in transaction code MIGO, M-I-G-O. So MIGO is the key code for goods receipt. Almost any goods movement. We'll see it in the topic of inventory management, what are various movement types. So first here you select what transaction you want to do. Whether you want to do the goods receipt or return delivery, cancel document, like that, any goods issues. So I want to do a goods receipt. This is the transaction that I want to do. And then what is the reference document? You can do it with reference to purchase order, inbound delivery, etc. So I'm doing it with reference to the purchase order and give the PO number here. So this is the PO which I have created and system will populate the movement type. 101 is the movement type. This is goods receipt against purchase order. Just press enter or you can click on this execute button. And system will pull the details from your purchase order. Okay. Now, if I click, there are various tab pages. You have the header and item level details. So, this is quantity tab. Say out of 10, only 5 quantity has been received. Then you can change it to 5. Then there it will have the movement type, the plant and the storage location. In purchase order data, you will see the purchase order number. Partner is the vendor code from whom you are receiving this material. So, if there is any freight, whom we need to pay this freight, that you can give that vendor. So, now what I'll do, I'll check this document. So, there is a check button here. And when I check, okay, first I need to flag this item okay. When you enter all these details, you need to enter this item okay, and then check. Now, instead of 10, I am receiving only 5 quantities, so system will issue a warning message that there is a shortage of 5 quantities. Your order was 10 and you are receiving only 5. You can process that goods receipt afterwards also. That quantity will remain open. So, here is a warning message, deficit of purchase order quantity 5. But this is a warning message, you can just press enter and continue. So now I'll post this document and I'll click on post. So the moment system will save this document, the post receipt will be posted. It will update your stock quantity and value. is the purchase order. I'll click on this document over here, or so this left side pane will go. And if you see here in the purchase order, there is no purchase order in the cabinet. And if you check in the status, this is this pure display before purchase. So you can see that ordered was 10, delivered was 0, and still to be delivered means pending is 10. Now what I'll do, I'll again go to the same purchase order display, click on this button, another document, same QR number, and click on another document. And here you can see the difference in the status. Out of 10, I have received the 5 quantity, and still to be delivered, the pending is 5. Also, you have one tab at the item level, purchase order history. And in this purchase order history tab, you can see that WE is the GR document. This is the material document which was purchased, and you have received 5 quantity. The value of that material was this much. This was the freight amount, etc. Now, after the purchase slip, we need to pay to the vendor, and that is done in transaction code MIRO, M-I-R-O. So, I'll go to transaction code MIRO. Vendor will send me the invoice, and I need to pull that invoice. Okay, in MIRO you have various options, so you can pull invoice, credit memo, debit memo, etc. So you see these details in topic of logistics invoice verification, what are the various options. So I'll select here invoice. You can do an invoice verification with reference to purchase order or any delivery note of the vendor, bill of lading, service entry sheet, etc. So I'm doing it with reference to purchase order, and I'll copy my PO number. So this is the purchase order number. Copy and paste it here. So enter incoming invoice. I'll paste it here. Okay. And whatever you see in the blue color, these are the mandatory sales. So I need the invoice date. I'll copy this data and put the same data here. This is the invoice data. Press enter. The system will take your data from the purchase order, and it will show you how much amount you should pay. You can also calculate taxes, and the tax formulation there was V0. So I'll select the tax code here V0, and I'll say calculate tax. So since it was a zero tax, the total tax amount is zero. And this is your material cost, which you can see here also. So your net payment is 97 euros. And this is the amount for which vendor has sent me the invoice. So this is the vendor invoice amount, and this is our liability, which system has shown. And here you see the difference. Now vendor invoice and our value is matching. So the balance is zero, and I can post this document. The signal is green. So I click on the simulate mode, and in simulate you will see what account system will pick and how much amount it will post. So that accounting person can have an idea of how much system is going to post to what account. So here you can see that vendor is credited with 97 euros and GRR clearing account is debited with 97 euros. And we'll run all these account settings and how these values are picked from where the system gets the GL account in the topic of material valuation, automatic account determination. This configuration, we do these configurations, and we'll learn it in a subsequent topic. So this is just the invoice verification. I'll click on post. And system will post this invoice. So with this vendor invoice is also posted. Once this document is posted, vendor invoice will get posted, and then system will update it in the purchase order history. So I go to this purchase order. This is the PO history. This WE was for the goods received, and when I refresh this is the refresh button. The system will update the invoice posted. So REL stands for invoice posted, and this is the invite poster. Okay. Now in the status tab, the invite was 0, and if I again display this, there is no refresh button on this tab. So system will give you the updated status. This invite, which was 0, now it has changed to the 5.3. So this is a simple normal purchasing cycle, and you should practice this cycle for some time, 2-3 times, and then you will understand the steps. And whenever you start practicing, so don't be in a hurry. Give attention to all the things on that particular screen. Say this button is new button. The same buttons you see in all other screens. What are the various map pages? What are the fields? They are significant. So just have a look around, and then do this cycle for some time, 2-3 times, 5 times, and then you will have an overview of the general purchasing cycle. Okay? So with this, I will stop. Thank you.